Hello everyone, welcome back to my mathematics channel. Today, I will focus on revision for SPM 2021 for mathematics paper 2 section A. I will try to make sure the questions are really hot so that you are well prepared for the hot question in SPM 2021. Okay guys, let's go through the hot question with me. I really hope that my sharing do help you to prepare for the hot question for SPM exam next year so that you will be cool in exam. Have fun! The Venn diagram in the answer space shows set A, B, and C such that the universal set is equal to A union B union C. So on the diagram in the answer space, you need to shade the set B prime. So the B prime is not include B, so that is how you shade the B prime. And this part also, C also is out of the B, so you should shade like this. So this is an answer for A, B prime. So make sure you shade properly for B prime. Alright, so now we will start with the B. A intersect B union C. So we'll do the one in the bracket first. So A intersect B is the part whereby A and B overlapping. So let's use the pencil to shade. I will use a yellow color to do the shading. So please follow the shading of the A intersect B as I shown here. So I'm going to shade now. So this is set A and we have set B. And the A and B are intersecting. So we are going to shade the part whereby A and B intersecting. Alright, or overlapping. This is the part where we call as A intersect B. Okay, clear. So now we need to continue with the union of C. So union means you have to take all the elements in set C. So now we are going to shade the C, the whole circle of C. So you need to shade. So I'm going to use a color pencil to highlight the region for C. So let's have a look of how I shade the region C. So I shade using yellow color. Alright, this is the part C, set C. So this is the answer for A intersect B and then union with the set C. Okay, all clear? So I'm sure everyone can do, right? So when you shade, make sure you shade the region correctly and don't let the shading out of the region. Alright, so that's about the set question for the shading. Now we'll proceed to the next question. You can always double check the answer after shading. Let's proceed to the next question. Diagram 2 shows a cuboid with horizontal base PQRS. K is a midpoint of the side of VQ. So let's have a look of the cuboid. So you're asking to find the angle between the plane and plane. Alright, so firstly, you observe the diagram carefully. Now, let's see the question asking find the angle between the plane PSK and the plane PQRS, right? So this is about the angle between plane and plane. So in order to find the angle between plane and plane, you actually will use your own method. There are many methods, right? So now I'm going to show you this method. So let's have a look of how I calculate the angle between the plane and plane. Before that, before I do calculation, I have to zoom to the angle that exists between the two plane, that is so called angle between plane and plane. So normally we will use a highlighter to highlight the plane PSK and PQRS. But there is another way I would like you to try. You circle PSK. This is the first plane. Okay, angle between plane and plane can be found by using this method. You circle P, circle S, and circle K. That is the first plane that you observe. Followed by, for the other plane, the blue one, I'm using the blue cross. I will cross out all the letters P, Q, R, S. Alright? So you cross like this using different pen. Okay, different color. So that you can observe there is intersection between the circle and cross. That is called between. So when there is a between, that means a circle and cross will meet. So actually, your answer for the angle between the two planes is either the two letters that you cross. So now we will try to write the angle. We prepare the three space with the symbol angle. So the center one should be the one you cross, but you have to choose either one. Okay, the first one is a circle. The letter to the left, we always use circle. It's a first plane that you circle just now, PSK. Okay, so now you look at the circle, alright? So there is a circle, three circle, but the one that you have is empty circle is the letter that you supposed to write down, which is letter K, right? So you write down the letter which empty inside the circle, nothing, is a blank circle. And then, okay, for the middle one, it must be the cross and the circle. Okay, middle one, the cross and the circle. Always remember that is the way to do. Okay, we follow the circle come first, and then the cross and the circle. Okay, so now you go to the diagram. Okay, observe, and which one is nearer to the point K? Which one? It looks like which one is nearer to point K, isn't it? You can observe clearly. The letters that with the shortest distance, with the nearest distance to point K. So actually, if you see, it should be which one? So can you tell me your answer? It should be letter. Okay, so your answer is? Yes, it should be letter. It's either that two. So you want to choose P or you want to choose S, you have to observe which one is the nearest to the K. It's near to K. Alright, so it seems like it's P, isn't it? Right? The P is very near to K. So when it is near to K, we will choose that letter and fill at the middle. That is the angle between the two planes. Okay? And the last one, of course, will be the letters cross. The cross just right below the K. Of course, it must be perpendicular. Okay, it must form a 90 degree. So the K and the other cross must be always perpendicular. Okay, so also you will say the shortest distance. So you choose the nearest. So this blue cross, it must be the nearest distance to point K. So which one you choose? Of course, it's right below, right? Right below the K, right? Okay, so the answer it should be what letters you will fill up there. You fill in the blank. Okay, so it should be this one, just right below the point K. So that is Q. Okay, that is how you figure out the angle between plane and plane. So next time, you always do like this. Use a circle and cross method. So the angle between the plane is angle KPQ, right? So now we need to find the angle, the size of the angle. So now in order to find the size of the angle, we always use trigo. So now we try to go for trigo. So you know TU is 12 centimeter, right? So TU is 12 centimeter. Okay, so that means the length should be the same for this PQ, right? Okay, we have to label all. In order to find the angle, you have to have side first, all the side first, so that you have to use a tua, okay, saw and the cha, right? Okay, this one is WP is 6 centimeter, but the question did mention K is a midpoint of the side PQ, right? So you go to the WP, you take the 6 and divide by 2. So isn't it 3 centimeter? Right. So now you see the triangle KPQ. It must be a right angle triangle. And it must be a right angle happen at the point Q. Alright. So you can apply tangent, right? Tor, tangent angle KPQ is 3 over 12, right? So then you can simplify, and then you press your calculator for that angle KPQ, right? So your answer is, you can shift tangent in order to get the answer, right? So yes, we have tangent angle KPQ is 3 over 12, right? So now shift tangent 3 over 12, you will get 14.04 degree. You have to write the angle KPQ equal to 14.04 degree. Please add one more sentence down there. Okay? Alright, so we have the angle for the KPQ ready. That means you know how to solve the angle between the plane and the plane. Alright, so remember, use a circle and a cross. And always use the nearest distance when you solve. Alright, okay, I hope you understand and try to do more using the method I teach you. Okay, for this one, is actually hot question. You know that you are Form 5 next year. Okay, maybe this year, you will see all these questions coming out like this in exam. So you're given a diagram, the total area of the square, okay, and rectangle is 64 centimeter square. So okay, you have to read the question carefully. So you have the square and you have the rectangle, and the area is 64 centimeter square. So the unit is very important. So it seems like the units are the same. So okay, so now we are going to write down the equation. So when square, okay, the formula for the area is x times x, right? It's easy, right? X times x is the area of the square. I'm sure everyone know. So you will write x square, followed by the rectangle. I'm sure you know area for rectangle is length times width, which is 2x times x plus 2, right? Okay, so you just write down like this, copy down, and then you do some simplification, example, you do expansion. Okay, now we are going to write the equation. Okay, so you try first. You take the x times x. Okay, then take the 2x plus, times the x plus 2 equal to 64 centimeter square. So let's do it now. So x times x is plus 2x times x plus 2 equal to 64. Firstly, you have to write your answer in order in a mathematical equation like this. Okay, so we are going to solve the value of x. Now, you need to do a simplification until you get a general form of the quadratic equation, right? So x times x, x squared, right? 2x times x, 2x squared plus 2x times 2 is 4x, right? And the 64 bring over will be minus, right? Minus 64 equal to 0. And then you simplify. You have how many x squared? 3x squared, right? Plus how many x? 4x minus 64 equal to 0. And now you need to factorize, okay? I'm sure some of you use a calculator to factorize, okay? But make sure you make sure it is a simplified form of general form, okay? Seems like it's a simplified form, so we can just factorize using calculator. So you press into your calculator, you get the answer, right? And then you make it into the factor that I teach you before. So make sure you write that this in exam. The working is very important. Don't just press the calculator and give me the answer, right? I don't want the answer. I want the working and the answer, okay? So now you have to let the factor equal to 0 and solve the x. So the x is... it seems like you're having negative, right? So for you, you must know that when x is negative, it's merely impossible because this is the length of the side of the square and the rectangle. So now you have to choose accordingly. You have to choose the answer which is logic. So so x equal to 4 is the right answer. And you have to reject the answer which is negative, right? So okay, so x equal to negative 16 over 3 must be rejected. Okay, you have to reject the negative answer because this is the length of the square and the rectangle. Okay, so that is how you solve the quadratic equation, that so-called hot question, but it's very very simple, right? So I'm sure you can do. Now let's proceed to the next question. This question is very interesting. It's about the volume. Alright. So let's have a look at the question. Diagram 4 shows a solid cuboid where a right cone with height of 24 cm base of diameter MN is removed from it. M and N are the midpoints of the edges EF and GH respectively. Alright, it is given that Vm equal to Vn equal to 25 cm by using pi equal to 22 over 7. Calculate the volume for the remaining solid. Right? So let's have a look at this question, how to solve. Now you're given a cuboid, right? So and the Vm is equal to Vn equal to 25. Can you please label your Vm and Vn equal to 25? And also you're given the Mn is equal to how many centimeter? So it's given 24 for the BG, right? Okay, now let's see, you are given the diameter Mn or not? Not given. So now we need to label the length of Vn 25 cm, right? Okay, we label first and then we need to work out the radius. Okay, so let's join the V to the center of the circle. and then you try to label the radius as X maybe, and the height of the cone, it should be equal to 24 centimeter, right? Okay, because the height of the cone is actually same with the B to G, which is the height of the cuboid, alright? So now label properly first before you can work out the radius. Okay, now can you see there is a right angle triangle? Remember the Pythagoras theorem? So you take the X as the radius, you label. So we are going to solve the radius using Pythagoras theorem. So because the diameter MN is actually consists of two radius, and the right below V, it should be the center of the circle. So from the center to the circumference, M or N is actually radius. So now you need to find the radius for the cone so that you can substitute into the volume formula for the cone, right? Okay, so now let's work out the radius by using Pythagoras theorem. Okay, alright, let's work out the radius, and then after that we will use a radius to find the volume for the cone. Okay, still remember the formula for volume of the cone is 1 over 3 pi r square h. R is the radius that we need to find. And also you need to find the volume for the cuboid, which is given. Okay, the side or the side given. Now we want to work out the radius first. So radius of cone is actually half of the EH. You can take EH over 2. So it's actually equal to the radius by using Pythagoras theorem. So we will take the hypotenuse, which is the longest one, which is 25, right, square. And then you have to minus out the shorter one is 24 square. Okay, so this is so-called Pythagoras theorem. And then, okay, we'll take 25 square minus 24 square, and you need to square root. Okay, then you can press your calculator for the radius of the cone. So you will get answer, which is 7, right? So with the radius 7, now you can label there 7 centimeter is the radius for the cone. So now I'm sure you will know how to find the volume for the cone, which is 1/3 pi r square h, right? Okay, let's work out together for the volume for the cone. Then we will actually minus out the volume of the cone from the cuboid, which is given on the side 14 and 16 and 24. So volume is cubic centimeter of the remaining solid. Okay, for the remaining solid, so we will use a volume for the cuboid, alright, and then we will minus out the volume for the cone, right? Right, we will use volume of the cuboid minus our volume for the cone, alright. So now we will just use a formula for volume of the cuboid. Just take the length times width times the height. Remember, for volume we always find the area for the base. So the base for the cuboid is actually rectangle. So you will take 14 times 16. Okay, that is the base, and then you times with the height. That is a basic formula for volume. Base times the height. So if cuboid the base is rectangle, so rectangle I'm sure you know is length times width, right? So the length is 16 and the width is 14, so you just multiply, and the height is 24. So we will just multiply all the three, 14 times 16 times 24. That is the volume for the cuboid, right? Okay, then we need to minus out the volume for the cone. The volume for the cone is 1 third pi. You must use a pi given, 22 over 7, times with the radius just now we obtained. The radius is 7, right? Square, alright. Okay, it's a square because the base for the cone is a circle. So it's 1 third pi r square. Okay, 7 square, and then you need to times with the height, which is 24. Okay, so now you can press your calculator carefully. You will get the answer 4144. So the volume is 4144 cubic centimeter. So if possible, please write the unit perfectly. Alright, if you tend to forget, you better don't write the formula, but I prefer my student to write the unit properly, 4144 cubic centimeter. Alright, let's proceed to the next question. This is about the solution of the simultaneous equation. You are not allowed to use matrix method, okay, for this one. You have to use substitution or elimination, okay. So we have two equations, 50x plus 56y equal to 690. Another one is 65x plus 48y equal to 711. So now you need to label equation 1 and equation 2. Okay, you label the equation like this before you solve. Alright, so now we are going to solve the simultaneous equation by using, and then after divide by 2, I will express maybe x in terms of y or y in terms of x, because I need to substitute into the equation number 2. Okay, now let's copy down the first equation and divide by 2. So you'll get 25x plus 28y equal to 345, right? Okay, after you simplify, it's okay if you doesn't want to simplify, no problem. So then you will write x in terms of y, or maybe y in terms of x. That means you need to shift all the y to the right hand side. It becomes 345 minus 28y dy by 25. That is so called x in terms of y. Then only you can substitute into equation number 2. Okay, so we label this is equation number 4. You can always label equation as you like. So this is number 4 after you express x in terms of y. So you will substitute number 4 into number 2. Okay, so now you look at number 2. You focus to number 2. You will write 64 times with the 345 minus 28y over 25, right? Okay, that's how you substitute. See or not, you take 65, and then when you see x, you will substitute with 345 minus 28y over 25, and then you plus with the 48y equal to 711. Now you just simplify. Okay, how to simplify by like this? So I advise you to times with 25 for every terms, because you need to make the denominator the same. So instead of make the denominator the same, you can just times with the denominator for every terms. Now you see, after you times 25 for every term, it looks very easy, right? So remember, you must times 25 for every term carefully like this. So you will have cancel out the 25 for the denominator. So 65 times 345, you get 22425. And then 65 times 28, you got negative 18200y. And then plus with the 48 times 25y, you get 1200y. And 711 times 25, you get 17775. And then you simplify, you got negative 620y equal to negative 4650. And then finally, you simplify your why. You will get the answer for the why. After you get the answer for the why, which is equal to -4650/-620. So your answer for why is equal to 10.5. So you label as equation number 5 because you need to substitute equation number 5 into equation number 3 or number 4 also can, up to you. So it depends. You can use 3, you can use 4. So we substitute the y into the x so that you will get the answer for the x. Alright, so for simultaneous equation, you must have the two answer, which is x value and y value. So it seems like I will substitute into number 3. So I think some of you might think of using number 4, which is easier, right? So it's okay, you can try many ways to do. So finally, you substitute carefully, you will get the answer for the x, right? So the answer for the x is 5.4, right? Are you getting 5.4? So that is the answer for the simultaneous equation with the x equal to 5.4 and with the y equal to 7.5. Alright, so we have solved the simultaneous equation. Now let's get started with another question. Alright, for this question is about mathematical reasoning. So number 6, write down premise 2 to complete the following arguments. Premise 1, all regular pentagons have 5 equal sides. Premise 2, not given, so you have to write on your own. Okay, for B, complete the following statement. So using the quantifier or sum to form the true statement. So make sure you use the quantifier either or sum to form a true statement. True statement. Okay, for C, state whether the following compound statement is true or false. 2x plus 3x equal to 5x or -8 less than -11. So you have to analyze the statement before you can write down the statement is true or false. Okay, for mathematical reasoning, let's see how to do. Now you please try first before we discuss. Alright, so let's see how to do. Okay, so write down the premise 2. So we have the OR statement and have 5 equal side. Has 5 equal side. The two similar one you highlight. Okay, and then we will ignore the OR. We just copy the one that are not highlighted. And also we are not going to use the OR. So we will start with the A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so for premise 2, we will start with the A, B, C, D, E is a regular pentagons. So make sure you copy correctly to form the premise 2. So A, B, C, D, E is a regular pentagon. Alright, so that is premise 2. You just highlight the similar one and you can cancel out the similar one. You also cancel out the OR and you always start from the conclusion. Alright, for B, complete the following statement by using the quantifier or sum. So you have to fill in the blank. You try OR. All prime numbers are odd numbers. Is it true? All prime numbers, we have prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, but 2 is not an odd number, so we cannot use all, so we choose sum, right? So some prime numbers are odd numbers. So remember, prime numbers, we have 2. Okay, please remember that. Okay, now we have settled this one for the quantifier. Now we will do C. Okay, state whether the following compound statement, okay, is true or false. This is a compound statement with the or, right? Alright, so let's have a look of how to solve the compound statement with the or. Now, in order to determine true or false, we need to analyze the statement. So you have 2x plus 3x equal to 5x. Right, so is it true? So you can state the true or false right down there. So 2x plus 3x equal to 5x, it is true, right? It is true. So the other statement is negative 8 less than negative 11. So negative 8, is it less than negative 11? Negative 8 is same size, bigger than negative 11, because when you have a negative with a smaller number, its value bigger, right? Okay, so this is a false statement. Negative 8 is a bigger number, bigger value than negative 11. So this is false. So for an or compound statement, if either one true, it will be true, right? Still remember, the compound statement for or, if either one true, it will be true. The last part for mathematical reasoning is this one, is the pattern. Number given, you have 5th day, you have 1 coin. Okay, for the 6th day, you have 4 50 cent coin. And for 7th day, you have the 9 coin. Right, okay, now Ali wants to save his money every day. He started to put a 50 cent coin into a box at the 5th day of January. Diagram 6 shows the total number of 50 cent coins that was kept by Ali in the box for the 5th, 6th and 7th day in January. Make a general conclusion by induction. Okay. For the total number of coins in the box in the end day in January. Alright, so we are going to write the conclusion. Okay, so let's study how to do. You need to write a general conclusion. So now the end, you start with the 5 because it's the 5th day. Alright, so when you do the general conclusion, you have to refer to the end term, end day. So now we will write down n equal to 5 first. You have one coin, just one coin, 50 cent coin, right? So you list out one 50 cent coin. Okay, so for n equal to 6, you do the same. So n equal to 6, how many coins? You can count how many coins are there. So we will write n equal to 6, then we will write how many coin there. So it should be 4. I use a red color to show the number. Okay, you have 4 coin, right? So you have 4 coins, 4 50 cent coins there. So then when n equal to 7th day, so n is equal to 7. So you list down n equal to 7, and also you count how many coins are there. So you have 3 times 3, which is 9 50 cent coins, right? You have 9. Okay, now you have the n start from 5, 6, 7. Now for n equal to 5, you have 1 50 cent coin, so you can write 1 equal to 1 square. For the n equal to 6 day, you have 4 coins, so you can write 4 is equal to 2 square, right? So then for the third one, you can write as 9 equal to 3 square. So we want to figure out the pattern, it should be some sort like square. So for the general conclusion, you will have something like square. So now you have 1 equal to 1 square, and then the 2 equal to 2 square, and 3 equal to 3 square. So now you need to figure out
how to write in terms of the N, but the N is starting from 5, 6 and 7. So let's say we substitute the 5, the 6 and 7 into the bracket first. Okay, we knew that the pattern will be square. So 5 will be minus out a number which is a constant to get 1. So of course you will minus 4. So is it apply for all the terms? You minus 4, you will get the same answer like previous you did. So 5 minus 4, you get 1 square, right? Ah, that is correct. For the second one, 6 minus 4, are you getting 2 square? Yes, you are getting 2 square. And 7 minus 4 square, are you getting 3 square? Yes. So that means the general conclusion that you will make, it should be you are having 5, 6, 7 onwards. So you should replace the 5, 6, 7 with an unknown or N. Okay, we take N and then minus 4 and then we square. So this general conclusion will apply for the rest of the term. Alright, so when N equal to 8, for the 8 days, you will have to have 8 minus 4 square, which is 16 square, right? So that is how you figure out how to write the general conclusion by induction. So finally, the answer is N minus 4 square, okay? And N is should be equal to 5, 6, 7, and 3 dot, okay? 5, 6, 7, and 3 dot. That is so-called general conclusion by induction. So I think that's all for today. Okay, so I really hope that my sharing do help you to master the mathematical skills for Form 4 and Form 5 syllabus. Okay, till then, I shall see you in my next video teaching. See you, bye bye, and have a nice day.